was a down-to-earth, generous, kind-hearted, life-loving, and selfish individual who was extremely inspirational to me.
Every time you saw that guy on screen, you just wanted to watch him. And it's sad that he's gone.
It's really tragic when somebody who was as gifted and talented is cut down at the early part of their career, because we always think about what more they could have offered.
David Kaplan, does your research tell you how all this started for Heath?
I mean, it's interesting. Sources tell people, in fact, that he was, you know, very troubled over in recent months and in recent years, because he was really affected a lot by his split from Michelle Williams. And even before that, you know, it's interesting. He spoke a lot about how he played that role of the Joker in that film and how that role was so encompassing to him. He played a dark character. He was a psychopathic character. And that, you know, by playing these roles, it affected him off screen as well. And he just really spiraled into this dark place that unfortunately included drug use, people, sources tell us.
So, doctor, it could be an occurrence. That begins you.
Well, oh, sure. Something has to incite the process.
Yes,
yeah, people, there are various ways that sort of the problem gets initiated. But once it's in, it's a medical problem, it's a biological problem, and it has a worse prognosis than most cancers. This is what people don't realize. First, we wouldn't hide the fact somebody had a pancreatic tumor or a brain tumor, but for some reason, this one medical condition we want to hide and shrink from. And the fact is, this is a medical disorder. It's a brain disease. It is triggered accidentally many times. Once it's underway, it has a treatment, and the treatment works.
The doctors who feed it, shouldn't they be delicensed?
Well, you know, Larry, you were asking, does this story die down now that the toxicology report has been revealed? But I am just what upsets me so much is that the issue of our society being one of pill poppers. If that issue dies down, then we're going to have more and more Heath Ledgers out there. We take pills for everything. You know, instead of taking 2 Tylenol, you take 4. Instead of going to the gym, you take your vitamins. Instead, you know, take an aspirin, everything. We want a pill to eliminate all of our problems without the work it takes to make ourselves better. And I think that's the issue that we need to be addressing now.
The prescription industry plays a part.
Well, everyone plays a part. But here, you know, my dad is a family practitioner. He always raised me at the idea that you only put a pill in your mouth when you absolutely had to, when the risks of taking a medication were outweighed by the potential problems of not taking the medicine. And so pills were last resorts. Medications are last resorts. Pills have become the answer for everything. And that's exactly what you're talking about. And there's even an epistemology. You need to be aware of this, Larry. Epistemology amongst physicians that the way to treat people that get accidentally hooked is to give them more medicine. That's a
belief.
That's an epistemology out there that people maintain. I am clearly not of that point of view, but that's part of what's swirling around here, is that there's disagreement about how to approach these problems within the medical community.
David, do you understand the attraction?
I mean, the attraction towards the drug use
pills,
and the pills.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's very common in Hollywood, unfortunately, because a lot of these celebrities, they're celebrities. They're put under so much stress. And the interesting thing here is that when they're so high up, one of their biggest fears is losing all that. So they enter this world of drugs, and it really takes them away from all this. So unfortunately, it's not that problem. And we know even a week before or so Heath Ledger died, we had Brad Renfro, another young star, also die, unfortunately, from use.
Right. David, by the way, your career more stressful than a celebrity's. It's true, and Larry's more stressful. The fact is, the celebrities, it's good to be a celebrity, but the stress is the potential of losing it, the potential of being exposed in some way because you are so out there in the public view, and it's very painful to them, the possibility of losing this thing that they value so deeply.
Right, but also, okay, let's be real. A lot of times in Hollywood, things are glamorized. Pills are glamorized. I mean, when you know, you see a person in a blue-collar town looking at us saying, oh, it's so stressful to be in Hollywood. They're like, look, if you can't pay your bills, that's stressful. So I think in this culture, in the Hollywood culture, it's glamorized. Popping pills is glamorized, and that is the problem. And that is an issue that should not go away after
this. And then the community behaves like what we call a sick family. There's a statement in there. We have an aphorism in the addiction field, which is you're as sick as your secrets. And this community maintains secrets like crazy. And you can't address these things. Look at Anna Nicole. She died because no one stepped up. I mean, you're dying. You've got to do something here. And it remained secret. No one talked about it. And somebody's dead. Maybe somebody else
dead.
Thank
you all very much. Dr. Drew Pinsky, Sean Robinson, and David Kaplan.